It's that time of year again. No, not the holidays, the Game Awards. Every year we gather as gamers to celebrate the best of the best in the industry, even though most of the awards normally include the same six games, but we celebrate nonetheless. And in a year that has been swallowed by the effects of a pandemic, we still managed to get quite a considerable amount of games, and not one, not two, but three new console releases. Xbox be showing off. But the award we all care about the most is, of course, the big one, Game of the Year. And the game that is deserving of this title that has managed to sneak its way into the nominees that released on March 20th of this year is undoubtedly Doom Eternal. I mean Animal Crossing New Horizons. Sorry, they're just so similar I get confused. In all seriousness, New Horizons has managed to make its way into the nominees and I'm not surprised at all. I fully believe this is deserved. New Horizons has already won Game of the Year at the Japan Game Awards in September, so Japan obviously knows what's up. And it's not the first time Animal Crossing has won this award. New Leaf won it in 2013. But if you're not on the same page and aren't quite convinced that New Horizons has earned this title, let's talk about it. When you look back at 2020 in gaming, I guarantee the first game that you're going to associate with this year is Animal Crossing New Horizons, and if it's not, then you're purposefully trying to ignore it. This game is synonymous with 2020. New Horizons was already a long-awaited title since the announcement of the Switch. Not the release, the announcement, because at the time of the Switch's official announcement, it had been 3 to 4 years since New Leaf had released. So by the time New Horizons did finally come out, it had been about 7 years since a main series Animal Crossing game. By this point, the Animal Crossing community were hyped and had become a lot bigger because I don't know if you all did what I did, but I was convincing people who had never bought an Animal Crossing game before to go and buy New Horizons. And it was working. People I know who had never even touched an Animal Crossing game before were willing to pick it up on launch just because it was getting a Switch release. But we do have to talk about the huge elephant in the room, the thing that probably helped New Horizons the most, and that is the timing of the pandemic. In March 2020, a lot of the world went into some form of lockdown or quarantine. Everything had shut down and seeing your friends or family was now out of the question. Or was it? New Horizons allowed people to hang out and spend time with their loved ones despite the regulations in place. You could visit each other's islands and help each other out by delivering rock or wood or trade items or even just watch meteor showers and the passing of villagers together. This allowed for some interesting things to take place like protests and campaigns for the US presidential election, but on the more wholesome side, fashion shows to show off your best outfits, proms and weddings for those who missed out on them in the real world, and even first dates. People even celebrated their birthdays in it. It's allowed people of all ages to go and spend time with those closest to them, and for me personally, I was able to connect and reconnect with people I hadn't seen in a while and knew I wasn't going to see for the rest of the year. It may have been a complete coincidence that the game was released at this time, but it is undeniable that Animal Crossing had a bigger impact because of it, and shaped how online interaction took place right through to the summer. It was a game that helped with people's mental health in a very difficult time in so many different ways. For some, it was an escape from the reality of working on the front lines of the pandemic. For others, it was just a way to cope with the onslaught of negativity that the news seemed to be showing every day by just being a beacon of positivity. And for some, it was just a way to occupy themselves or their kids when going outside was just not an option. It helped so many with loneliness and was the slow routine game that we all needed. And by we all needed, I mean we all needed, because our next point is all about how much New Horizons sold. If you don't keep up with the numbers, then it may be new information to you that as of August, Animal Crossing New Horizons is the second best-selling Switch game of all time, with over a third of Switch owners owning a copy and only being beaten by Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. It had sold 22 million copies in total, with Mario Kart at 26.7 million. But don't forget, New Horizons had done this in the space of 4 months, whereas Mario Kart has been out for 3 years. It had sold more copies than any PlayStation 4 exclusive ever has. As of September 30th, however, Nintendo revealed Animal Crossing had sold 26 million copies, which is incredible, although still losing to Mario Kart, which is now at 28.9 million. It has completely overtaken the lifetime sales of many Switch must-plays like Breath of the Wild or Mario Odyssey, and we haven't even got to the holiday season yet, so who knows what these numbers will look like come January. You can't deny the numbers. A game this popular has to be Game of the Year, right? You think that Game of the Year should have slightly more substance than high sales figures in shaping how the online community interacted for a few months? Okay, then finally, let's talk about how this is the best Animal Crossing game yet. Don't get me wrong, it still needs some improvements, but that's another video. And no game is perfect. But the game is undoubtedly beautiful and the best looking Animal Crossing yet. The lighting effects are the best they've ever ever been, and every screenshot of this game is not just cute, but gorgeous. The villagers look the best they ever have, even if their personalities could use some tweaking. However, it's the new additions of crafting and terraforming that are so welcome. When crafting was introduced in Pocket Camp, it was just a matter of when it would show up in the main series, and personally, I love it. I really like having something to collect and then working towards building it, even if it's only for an hour. Collection is a big part of the series, and adding something to that list is more than welcome. Terraforming as well is just exactly what we needed in the next step of Animal Crossing. Once New Leaf allowed us to place things around the town, people wanted more creative opportunities to make their towns unique. And as much as I might break down because I have too much control over the design of my town, for a lot of people it has been the exact thing they asked for, and it's allowed for so much more individuality. On top of the new additions, Nintendo are giving us free updates on quite a frequent basis, and even though some of them seem expected, such as the holiday updates, they definitely improve upon some of the previous game's versions. For instance, the inclusion of more diverse hairstyles was something that players had asked for quite some time, and this recent update shows that on some level the team are listening to what players want. And in what other game series can you create an army of puppies or spend time doing yoga with your fluffy neighbours? And you can argue that because I'm having to include the updates that the base version of the game wasn't good enough, I'd still say you were wrong, to an extent. I also believe any game can become stale if you play it for hours each and every day, and Animal Crossing has never been intended to be played that way. It's supposed to be slow, and there is always supposed to be something you are working towards. And although some people may dismiss these claims as recency bias, I really don't think it is. I think Animal Crossing games have just got better with each iteration, and they have always been for everyone, and New Horizons is no different. Just this time, it brought the world together without even meaning to. So that's why I believe Animal Crossing New Horizons deserves not only the nomination for Game of the Year, but actually deserves the win. And you can cast your votes now, so if you want it to win, now's the time to vote. I feel I've heard that a lot this year. If you liked this video, please give it a like, leave a comment about why you think New Horizons should win, or maybe why you think it shouldn't. Subscribe to see more from me, follow me on Twitter and Instagram to see what else I get up to, join my Discord for a fun, wholesome time, and I'll see you next time. Bye!